Hi, this is Travis with POSGuys.com. Today we're going to take another look at scanning and printing. This is a little different than the previous iteration that we've done. In that first version, we set it up so that when you scan any barcode, as soon as you scan it, it'll send the print command right afterwards. So it just one scan, one print. We're going to do it a little differently this time. We're going to set it up so that you can scan multiple barcodes, and when you're ready to print, you scan the barcode to print. So once again, I'm in the Motorola 123 scan. You can configure this using the manual and just scanning the correct barcodes. The 123 scan is a little easier to use, especially for advanced programming. Again, I'm going to be programming an LI4278. This process would work for multiple Motorola scanners, most of all the current versions. This would work for, they all have enough memory to do this same type of programming. I'm going to create a new configuration file. I'm going to select USB. It's going to load up. There's the scanner that I'm going to program. I'm going to select it. And I'm going to come down here into Modify Data. And then I'm going to select Create a New Rule. The rule name, we're going to put in print command. For the code type, you can leave it as all codes, and that's what I recommend. If you know specifically what type barcode you'll be using, whether it's code 3 of 9, code 128, if you're going to scan a UPC code, you can select that code type just to be a little more specific. But using all codes should work fine. The most important here, important part is this line that says string. This is where you're going to specify your barcode. If you're printing your own barcodes, you can print using whatever you want. You can use like the word print, or you can use print. You can write out control P that won't necessarily print automatically, but some people just know that control P usually means print. Or you can just use numbers. In this case, I have a barcode that is 123456. So that's what I'm going to use. Down here, you have the add action. When you click Add Action, you'll get a little dialog box that pops up, and you have a few different options. What you're looking for is the send value. When you click Send Value, it'll give you some additional options here. We want the send ASCII key. And there's our options. We're looking for Control P because that's what's going to tell most programs to print. So there I selected Control P. I'm also going to click Save and Add Another. If you want to print automatically and not have to select OK in the dialog box, then under Send Extended Key, you're going to look for Enter. In this case, where I do want to use the dialog box, I'm going to not do that. But what I am going to do is I'm going to go down to Beep, and I'm going to select thrice. I just want to hear a triple beep instead of the normal beep to know that I'm going to print. Click Save. And then on the screen, you'll see the send ASCII key and the beep thrice. We're also going to need another action. If you saved like you are now, then it will print when you scan 123456. But it won't do anything else. When you scan anything else, it's just going to beep. Nothing will be sent to the screen. So we're going to have to tell the scanner to send data like normal. What I'm going to select is add a rule from library. Motorola's provided some simple commands. This one I'm going to select is append and enter. You select that and then click select rule. What it does is send all that remains, basically send the barcode, and then send enter. Instead of send enter, you can do a send tab if you rather have a tab, or if you just wanted to send the data and nothing else. If you remove the send enter, then it'll just send the information. So those are the two rules that we need. From here, we click done. It kind of verifies your settings, and then you hit load to scanner. I have a couple different scanners plugged in, but if you have a single scanner, it'll show your model there. And then you just hit load to all scanners. and it'll load the information to the scanner. That's all you have to do in 1, 2, 3 scan. Once this is done, go ahead and close the application. I'm going to jump over to the camera and I can show you how the barcode scanning and the printing works.
Here I have my LI4278 and my test barcodes. This monitor has just a basic text editor open, and there is my printer. What I'm going to do is I'm going to scan a bunch of barcodes. It scans into my text editor, and then this big middle barcode here is my 123456. When I scan that, you got the triple beat, and the print dialog appeared on the screen, and then if you click OK, it goes and heads and prints. If you wanted to print automatically without going through the print dialog, you can do that. You just gotta set up that first rule to do an extra carriage return, and then it will also print automatically, and you don't have to do the on-screen dialog. So that's basically how you can do a different version of the scan and print application. For more information, to download the manual, to download 123 scan, or to purchase a barcode scanner, please visit us at POSGuys.com. Thanks.